Traveling to a new place can be exciting, but it's very easy to get caught up in the thrill of the adventure and forget what's most important. And that's to keep security and safety consideration in mind while traveling, especially when you are traveling somewhere new. Tara Cadwell is a lifelong criminal justice professional and the CEO of Staying Safe and Secure. She's here to share some advice on making sure you stay safe and aware during your next vacation. Welcome, Terrell.
Thanks, Brittany. Thanks for having me back.
So really, we just get so excited to travel. When we're on our way, when we're on that flight or in the car, whether we're driving or flying, we just want to get there and have fun. But why is it so important to make sure we plan and we get ready for this?
I think it's really important, Brittany, because some minor incident could actually ruin your entire vacation, and we don't want that. You know, you want to go and have a great time, but also to come back safely and just to be able to know that you're having a great time and not have to worry about a lot of things.
So one of the first things before we even go to stay safe and secure is to plan and do research.
Exactly right.
What advice do you have when it comes to that?
Well, one of the things to do is to make sure that you know maybe some of the scams, the current scams that might be going on. There are to each location, whether you're in Miami or Thailand, there can be some things to watch out for. Also to register with an embassy if you're going overseas or with the State Department. And that's really a big one because you may not be paying attention to the news while you're on vacation. And if you're not, the embassy can get a hold of you quickly, and if you'd have to evacuate for some reason, security or travel changes or maybe a natural disaster, that's really an important safety piece.
So when it comes to trip insurance, because I'm looking at that one and I'm thinking, okay, every trip I've taken in the U.S., I've never bought that trip insurance. Why would I want that?
Well, for one thing, it would help protect you if something happens at the last minute that you couldn't go on your trip. But also, when you're traveling, I mean, you could get an injury. And I know this has happened in our family before. My daughter hurt her knee badly, and she had to get some medical care. And a lot of places require cash up front, or they don't accept American currency. And if they don't have a hospital there in a local location where you are that can take care of the injury, if it's a head injury or a bad cut or a broken ankle, they may have to air vac you out. So those are some things to think about. And trip insurance just helps those minor incidents go away or be less stressful.
And when it comes to traveling, why do we want to blend in?
We want to really blend because you're not traveling to attract attention. And one of the things, like, for example, Brittany, standing out on a corner with your map spread out and looking, you're just kind of drawing attention to the fact that I don't know what I'm doing. And you're already more susceptible to deception and other things anyway. So one of the things, just to wear clothes like the locals wear, maybe carry a bag with you from a local business. Those are good ideas. And this isn't the time to wear that irreplaceable necklace that you got for your anniversary or to show off your new diamonds. You don't want to attract a crime of opportunity.
So that really goes back to planning and research, because if you're going to a different place across seas and they have a different culture and dress different, should we be dressing like that?
I think that we should. Try to do everything you can. In some places, it's even illegal to not have certain dress. You know, for women in some places there are, or it's advisable to do that so you're not drawing attention to yourself being from another country.
Okay, we have some more tips to go through also that you want to mention. And making friends.
Yeah. Brittany, that's really a good idea because especially if you're traveling alone, you want to make friends with a reputable person at the hotel or at a restaurant, have them call a cab for you. And also if you take guided tours, not only do you make a friend with the tour guide, they can really help you understand some other attractions you want to see, but you may see some other people on the trip that are on the guided tour with you. And sometimes those are lifelong friends. There are other travelers like you. One of the other things, and this is like, I kind of am like this with almost any situation, but if you're drunk or high, you really put yourself in an extremely vulnerable position, especially if you're already in a foreign country or in a different location. You're super vulnerable. So it's really good to have a clear head and pay attention.
Now, sometimes we're traveling for work and we are completely alone. Yeah. What advice do you have for that, especially when it comes to car rides, maybe if you're taking an Uber or a Lyft? What do we need to be aware of if we're all by ourselves?
Wow, Brittany, that's a good point. I was so excited because there was new technology that Uber brought out, and I think Lyft is following suit. And it is, with all the different scares that have happened, they have a new PIN code system. So not only can you watch the driver's license plate and the car, the make of the car and the driver's name, but there's a PIN code that actually pings when the driver gets close to you and to your phone. And also, you can also access 911 on the app. and they'll know where you were picked up, what your route is, and where you're going. So I thought those are really cool new tips.
Who and what information should we be sharing with about our trip before we even leave?
Well, for one thing, really avoid social media. You don't want to say, having a great time on the beach in Aruba, see you all next Thursday. I mean, that just kind of invites anybody else who might want to, you know, take advantage of your home situation. But also, if you share too much when you're away, that can make you vulnerable as well to you know, coming to your hotel or following you or something like that. You don't want to do that.
But we should let maybe a family member or a loved one know exactly what we'll be doing.
Absolutely right. And lots of times the internet isn't accessible in every location. So whenever it is, it's really a good idea to touch base with your family and let them know where you've been and what's the next plan ahead.
So Terrell, what do we do if we find ourselves in a questionable situation?
I think one of the good things to do, and this kind of goes back to planning, Brittany, is to make sure you have on you the addresses and phone numbers of key places like the police department, your hotel. Sometimes we don't always know our hotel and we might forget it if we're in a very stressful situation. So you have that in the embassy and any other key phone numbers. So if something does go wrong, you can do that. Also, I really do recommend, and most of the sites, the research sites and travel recommend, that you at least know a few self-defense moves so that if you do have to get away from somebody quickly, you at least can get away. Also, an emergency whistle would be a good idea, or even a rubber doorstop to make sure your locks are secure at the hotel or wherever you're at.
All right. Thank you so much, Terrell, for coming in and giving us all these great tips to help us stay safe.
Thanks, Brittany.